has been someone I have been playing his music here. You've heard the music. Maybe you can just play this one for a minute, so that
Royal Sam. Watu wengine wanahitaji kusalimiwa. Salamu kindogo tu.
Tupatie namba yake tumuzalimi.
Get out.
Tunenge namba yake mwa tumukethie.
Tumukethie mwa.
Tumukethie.
Ai.
Tumuzalimie.
Akethwe mwa.
Akethwe.
Ai.
Mwa tumukethie. Atile kilo momwana.
Watu wengine wanahitaji shikamo. Hmm?
Wengine wanaitanji kuzalimiwa.
Get out.
Tambia zingine zinataka zalamu.
Akia nani?
Aki kushinda tutumie namba yake. Na wengine sio zalamu ya mundomo peke yake. Wengine wanataka makofi shangwe na vigelegele.
Wacha ni kuambia maina.
Tupatia namba yake tukuzalimie.
Salamu tu.
Tunenge namba yake mwa tumukethie.
Mukethie mwa
tumukethie.
Ai.
Tumuzalimie.
Akethwe mwa.
Akethwe.
Ai.
Mwa tumukethie. Atile kilo momwana.
Ukiona mtu ametulia, labda amezalimiwa asumbui.
Kuna gengine kalini sinya sana.
Hakiao.
Nilika mbele kandeti ya njioni. Kaka kunja na mandemu wengine watano. Wakakula kama watu wanahama.
Get out.
Alafu wakaniambia nilipe mbilu yote ya chakula.
Sasawa.
Nikanjifanya nimeenda kunjisaindia.
Piu.
Nikalipa yangu na nikatoka.
Let me tell you.
Nakwambia walisalimiwa.
Maina.
Salamu.
Shikamo.
Salamu.
Ai. Maramba mwanangu.
Tupatie namba yake tumuzalimie.
Salamu tu.
Tunenge namba yake mwa tumukethie.
Tumukethie mwa.
Tumukethie.
Ai.
Tumuzalimie.
Akethwe mwa.
Akethwe.
Ai.
Mwa tumukethie. Atile kilo momwana.
Waja nikwambie ndugu yangu. Wengine hata wahitaji kusalimiwa na mundomo peke yake. Wengine wanahitaji makofi shangwe na vigelegele. Eh? Akikulemea wewe tutumie namba yake tu.
All right, MC Njagi, habari yako? How are you?
I'm good, bro.
Yeah, I came across your YouTube channel and I saw a very very sad a video you had put there that you are leaving content creation because life had become difficult and your things have just gone under. What happened, sir? Maybe you can share with us briefly so that we understand how bad governance and bad leaders can drive your dreams into a grave.
Well, first of all, so much kwa sababu ya kunipea hii chance, and thank you also for reaching out, because I've been going through tough times in my life, and very few people have reached out, and most of them wale wanakupigia wanakuambia don't give up. So at the end of the day, don't give up doesn't do anything for you. Don't give up doesn't solve any problem you have. At least, so I want to thank you because of reaching out and at least giving me this chance ya kuongelesha wa Kenya, and maybe let them know what has been going on in my life. So most of the people know me as MC Njagi. MC Njagi, kutoka kitambo nimeishi kuimba easy comedy music. So most people know me by the song ngombe ni ngombe. Wale wenye wamekuwa wakisikia ngombe ni ngombe tu ngombe, I have seen people using that sound, but very few people know me. People know my music, but people don't know me. People don't even follow me, but nimepata watu wanatumia hiyo music yangu hadi kwa advertise makampuni zao. When you try to reach out, wanakuambia enda kwenye unataka. we don't care. Hiyo music umeweka kwa public domain itumike. So this is my story. Nilianza ile time ya Wavinya Ndeti, the current governor wa Machakos. Kuna kitu alisema hapo, alisema aliondoa lesipite, and I used that. Nikachukua hiyo nini, hiyo slogan yake. Ilifika tu mahali ikaisha, nikachukua nikaimba aliondoa lesipite with that accent ya Kikamba, and hapo ikaanza kupik tena. Nikaanza kuitwa interviews, nilienda interview 10 over 10 with wakati Willis Laburu walikuwa huko. Nikaenda on NTV The Trend with the late Jambi Koikai, na pia nikaenda K24, lastly nikarudi nikaenda BBC. Nilifanyiwa interview mingi sana. That is when the former CS Honorable Moses Kuria called me, akaniambia ningependa hiyo tune, ningependa utuimbie song ya Jubilee. So that is what I did, na tukaenda tukapatana tu mahali tukaongea nini, and then at the end of the day akaniita road show. Tukaenda road show Mombasa. So me, I was thinking ninaenda kufanya hiyo road show nilipwe pesa ya kutunga song ya Jubilee na pia pesa ya kufanya road show. Hiyo pesa ya kufanya road show for 1 week. But to my surprise, the only pesa nilipatiwa ni hiyo ya road show peke yake. And for that whole week nilipatiwa 150,000. 150,000 for 7 days, sikulipwa pesa ya nini. Pesa ya studio ni mimi nilitoa, pesa ya kushoot video ni mimi nilitoa, pesa ya kila kitu mimi ndio nilitoa. But I thought I was going to be paid pesa ya music, pesa ya studio, pesa ya music, pesa ya msanii. But the only money I got from Honorable Moses Kuria was 150 shillings peke yake, and 150,000 shillings peke yake. And the other artists wenye tulikuwa nao kama akina Bahati and what have you, they were paid millions of money. But because mimi nilikuwa startup, nobody hakuna mtu alikuwa na shughuli na mimi. So my journey has been nilienda Churchill kwanza the first time. I don't blame anyone, because probably it's the truth. I was told sina talent. kama kawaida watu wengine, I was told sina talent, na nikatoka nikaenda nikafanya mambo zangu. Few months down the line, the Churchill himself called me, nikaenda show yake, and hiyo mambo ikaenda hivyo. But few years down the line, I tried to reach out to these people nikiwaambia, since tumeshawahi work na nyinyi, there is something I'm going through. I'm talking about the current situation that I am in right now. I've tried to reach out, I've tried even to message them.
What is the current situation? Can you be specific and probably narrow the narrative?
Yeah, so few months ago, around 3 months ago, I went into a debt. Niliingia kwa deni fulani, and niliingia kwa deni ndio ni I tried to better my life, kwa sababu mambo things were very tough after now the COVID-19. Mambo ya entertainment na music industries zilienda chini, so I went into a debt. So ikafika mahali nikashindwa kulipa hiyo deni. So I tried to reach out to people, the people that I know and the people I've worked with, thinking since tulisaidiana na I helped you build your brand in this manner, so at least the least you can do ni kunisaidia wakati niko na issue, because wewe wakati uko na mambo huwa unanipigia ninakusaidia. So nobody reached out. I have sent nimejaribu kuomba watu until now nika, if you look at my YouTube imeenda dormant because nili zile vitu zenye nilikuwa nazo, zile equipment zenye nilikuwa natumia, camera, equipment za studio zilienda na ile loan, zilienda na like nilikuwa nimezieka zikiwa collateral, hizo zilienda na hiyo loan. The loan was not actually that big, the loan was 100k, na zile equipment nilikuwa nazo zilikuwa za around 300,000 or 400,000. So since nilikuwa nimeweka collateral na nilikuwa nime, walikuwa wamekuja wakaona mahali naishi, they came and they took my equipment.
So this last music, letter number to msalimie, I can, yes, see the quality is not good. You used what? Used a phone to record it?
Yes, if you check that quality, I used my phone to record, and I told people this is the last song I'm doing since I, because you see that song nilikuwa nimefanya before vitu zikujiwe. Nilikuwa nimeirecord before vitu zikujiwe. So sasa nikasema since iko hapa na that is the current trend yenye inaendelea sasa hizi, I said wacha tu ni shoot na simu tu vile iko. If you compare the quality for that last song and others, utaona quality ziko tofauti because the others I was using a camera, but now that I said wacha tu niitoe vile iko isipotelee tu hivyo.
So that's why all right. And now so now where do you stay? Where do you live? Because I know things are bad for you. Things are not. Where do you stay? You didn't tell me where you live.
Right now I'm living with a friend. Mm-hmm. A friend of mine mwenye ako na studio yake tu hapo kwa nyumba, but I staki kumuharibia jina, but let me say this, I have been trying even to make content with his equipments.
Mm-hmm.
But kuna vile wewe unajua ukiwa unakaa na mtu, kuna vile anakuangalia na nini anakuambia ni kama anakuambia hizi vitu unafanya mimi hazinisaidii nini wewe. So sasa unaona I opted to kuachana tu na nini, nikaachana tu na muziki, nikasema acha tu nitafute kazi mahali tu nitapata.
Okay. Are you currently undergoing some form of clinical depression?
Sorry?
Are you going some form of clinical depression as we speak right now? Do you think your mind is just in a mess?
My brother, let me be honest with you. Have you ever felt like your brain is missed you? Mm. There was a certain time I went on top of a building and my mind was telling me jump. my head was just telling me jump. Like any, I have nimefika mwisho ingine yenye unashindwa what is the purpose of continuing to live, because even what you are living for is not there anymore. The people you are trying to entertain, unaenda kuambia wakusaidie hadi unaweka capable na huko kwa nini wanasema ni kiki, unatafuta kiki, unaweka ka nini capable huko kwa TikTok, wanaanza kukutukana. Mimi nikikuonyesha zile matusi nimetukanwa, until I ended up kutoa hizo video kwa TikTok na nikatoa pia kwa YouTube, nikaambia watu for now mimi nimeshaenda. Maybe mimi nikifanikiwa nitarudi.
All right. Just hold on there. Pole sana bro. You know, people are going through a lot right now, and it is very painful when you see people coming on X kwanza kutukanana. You know, people are going through pain right now. As a country, truly, ile pain ni watu wako nayo uchungu. We cannot afford to be divided. Honestly, we can't. This is just one story. How many stories are out there that we are not highlighting? I have Maget Wade from Senegal. How are you? This is a young man from Kenya who is an artist, has been choked in debt. Just a representation of our countries in the continent. What is your comment on what the continent is undergoing? I'm sure you've seen Kenyan protests. They are also planning more protests this week. What is your comment on whatever is going on in the country? Margaret.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Americ. I'm very happy to be here. At first, I was like, am I supposed to be here? I'm not Kenyan. So, but I think we're all brothers and sisters. So thanks for having me. And MC, I am so, so sorry to hear about everything that you've been going through. And I'm so glad, you know, when you were in that building that you eventually made the decision you made to stay with us. And please stay with us. It will get better. I know that when I say these things, people think I'm crazy, but Africa will get better, and it will get better in our lifetime. And that's actually what I want to talk about. So, Americ, when you ask me about, you know, the state of this continent of ours, you know, I'm from West Africa, and I'm sure you guys all know about what's going on over there. The coups have made their comeback, you know, because our youth oftentimes thinks this is, everything else has failed us, let us try this. Although, what I'm here to share with you guys is pretty much the way I'm looking at all of us. At the end of the day, I look at our problems and I literally can put it into one bucket. And that bucket has to do with our lack of prosperity. We're poor. We're just the poorest region in the world. You can say, how can you say that? We have all of these natural resources. We have all of these great young people. Yes, all of those are riches, but that's not what I'm speaking of. What I'm speaking of is, you know, basically us being prosperous nations. And if we look around, we're not. You know, I think what MC just talked about, it's not talking about somebody who's being prosperous. So for me, you know, I spend my whole life trying to figure out why is it that this is the case right now? Why is our region in the situation it's in right now? And as many people for the longest time, I thought it was simply because we, you know, because of colonialism, because of racism. I was there. I was in that mindset for the longest time. And eventually I became an entrepreneur. And I was an entrepreneur. I'm right now building my third company. What my companies all have in common is there's always a sister company somewhere in Africa. In my case, it's Senegal, and the other one usually in the U.S. because we manufacture and produce in Senegal, and our biggest retail marketplace is the United States of America. So the first time I did that exercise of building a business and having these two sister companies, I was shocked. I was just shocked at the discrepancy in the ease of doing business from both places. Needless to tell you that the one place where everything felt really cumbersome, bureaucracy, you know, choking me every turn I go at all levels, whether it's at the business registration level or, you know, the labor laws level, the tax code, the permits, anywhere you turn, it's just like, it's a nightmare. And I had to compare that to where I was doing business back the first time when I did this. It was in California. So, and it's interesting because California is not even the most free state in all of the union. It's next to the last in terms of being a free state, meaning like California is still the place where it is still hardest for, you know, we don't have as much, you know, economic freedom as the rest of the U.S. has. And then some people might be like, oh, then why is California so rich? Well, you'll be surprised to hear that if you remove Silicon Valley and Hollywood out of California, California would be the poorest state in all of the United States of America. But people don't know that. But anyway, I'll digress. So as I was doing this, as I was doing business, I realized, wow, it's why, and then I thought to myself, oh, I guess it's because we're so poor that it's so hard and cumbersome to do business home. And conversely, it's because America is so prosperous, that's why it's so easy to do business. But the minute I said that, and this was after a couple of decades of searching, why are we poor? And hearing people tell me, oh, it's because, you know, blacks and browns are just not as smart as white people. You guys are lazy. You guys are always fighting each other. So basically, supposedly there's something wrong with us. But in any case, as soon as I figured, I said, oh, we're poor, that's why it's so hard, and they're rich, that's why it's so easy to do business, just come to think to myself, wait a second, poverty is solved by prosperity. Prosperity is built by entrepreneurs. What do entrepreneurs need? They need an enabling business environment. But wait, you just told me that our nations are the ones where it's hardest to do business. And conversely, those are the wealthy nations of the world is where it's the easiest to do business. And when I came to that, my whole worldview changed. It made so much you know, sense. And then that's pretty much why I've been after this issue of another way you could call it, it's bad law and bad governance. And that's why I've been very excited to hear that the youth of Kenya is actually now finally putting its finger on this. And by the way, you're going to say, oh, well, because we hear everybody talks about bad governance, and I've been seeing people oftentimes, you know, interchange the two without no problem. What do you mean by that? People confusing bad governance with bad government. Those two are really not the same. And even when we talk about bad governance, which is, what I'm worried about today is that the young people, you know, who are finally talking about bad governance and not necessarily bad government, I don't think, I'm just a little bit worried that even there, we might not be very clear about which bad governance are we going after? Because there's one that we really need to go after. If you ask me, I think it's going to be the domino that we need to hit first. So that one then touches all the other ones. So what am I talking about here? When we say bad governance, at least we're not saying bad government. When we're saying bad governance, many people, I find, are confusing in Africa. They're usually thinking about, this political corruption, what I call political corruption. And so, but political corruption, it's still not the same as the corruption that comes from, you know, overly regulating the private businesses, meaning small, medium-sized enterprises simply, you know, have a hard time being born and growing in many African nations. So there is a big discrepancy there. So many times when we talk about bad governance, we're just talking, many of us are talking about, well, you know, our natural resources should be handled better. Our, you know, our the politicians should not use their power to be able to turn around and, you know, give contracts to their friends. You know, we all hear about that. We all know about this. All of that, by the way, it's wrong. I agree. It's wrong. It's not right. But for me, I think that the one governance we need to really focus on is the one where we're looking at what's going to help free our entrepreneurs. Because the way I look at it is we free the entrepreneurs because they're the wealth creators. Entrepreneurs go on to create many, many companies. Those many companies create many, many jobs. Those many jobs give to many, many, many people a source of income. Many, many people having a source of income means that you have a solid middle class. Then my take is we let that middle class, once it's constituted, that middle class then go to fight head to head with the government and deals with the political corruption that all of us are fighting with. So if you ask me today, what I'm very worried, as I'm seeing Kenya, and I am so behind everybody in Kenya, right? I'm so behind all of you. But my plea to everybody is going to be, please, please, there's a fork here. There's a fork, and we have to see it for what it is. We have rarely seen it, and that's why we're still where we are. We just want people to better manage our natural resources. We just want people to no longer give their friends a deal. Because even if, let's say, we had the best, you know, management of our natural resources, and yet you still did not have a business environment that allows small and medium enterprises to be born. A place where Rosaline is from, middle of nowhere somewhere in Kenya, she knows absolutely nobody in government, and she should not have to know anybody in government, but she's got a wonderful idea and she's ready to work hard. She should be able to jump into what we call entrepreneurship and keep moving. That's not the case right now. There's just too many laws, too many regulations. Everybody is struggling. So at this point, guys, what I'm hoping that we do is that we go after that governance. And you, in a way, have started doing that, America. So I'm just going to say, you have started doing that because you're starting to look at taxes. You're starting to look at all of these things. But this is the caveat on that. This issue is not going to be solved with piecemeal legislation. The best way for you guys to think about this is laws and regulations. The best way to think about it is, like, let's say you're thinking about X, okay? So, you know, X is this platform. Most of us, we just see X. You know, you type your comment, you do all of your things, it's working, you're happy. But everything that makes X happen is the algorithm that's behind it. It's millions and millions and millions of lines of code, right? And so the laws and regulation is the same thing. If you put together all of these laws and regulations that rule the life of a business, you're going to see millions and millions of lines of code, each one of them being a regulation and or a piece of law. That's what you're going to see. Now, imagine, and you heard many times even X saying, Elon Musk saying, we're probably going to have to start all over because this whole thing is a mess. It's so messy. Yeah, they were able to clean up a lot, but there's such a thing as at some point, things are so messy, you don't even know anymore what's putting what, and it could take you a lifetime, literally, of you trying to figure it out and still not getting to what you need to get to. Sometimes you got to start over. And so this is where I think, let us be very careful not to be tempted by that, piecemeal legislation. Because if we are tempted by that, by saying, on the tax laws, do this, do that. On the labor laws, do this, do that. And then they happen, maybe they happen, especially not at the same time. Because what you need is a critical mass of these, legal infrastructure to happen all at the same time for it to really make the critical difference that we need and that we need now for the real change that we need to happen. Otherwise, we're still going to be dealing with little incrementals, a few more jobs here, a few more jobs there, which is not going to take care of a millions and millions of young people we have coming to an age of needing a job every single year.
All right, hold in there, bring you back. Right, thank you very much, Maget. She's very wonderful. She talks a lot about business and how bad governance and bad government have a direct influence on our business. So ukiona hao watu wa government propaganda wana push up a propaganda, hawaelewi ni nini watu wanapitia through. Morara, I didn't know you are an advocate.
Morara. Yes, I'm a lawyer.
Oh, great.
Yes, thank you. And the previous speaker, she has really insisted on laws. Probably before I get into what I wanted to say, it's good to remind her that in Kenya in particular, and this is just a point of information, we don't have a shortage of laws. We just have infidelity to the law. People don't follow even the few laws that are there. And we have very lazy politicians and very lazy parliamentarians who don't even sit to research and create our own laws. They pick maybe, for example, the law on data protection. They pick the EU law or the UK law. Then they copy-paste it wherever it written the United Kingdom, they write Kenya.
Fact, we've lost you. Fix your mic. Fix your mic, please.
Yes, my mic is on. Can you hear me now?
Fix it again. You are so far.
Can you hear?
Yes, there. There.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, there's
that is okay now.
Yeah, go on.
All right. So I'm just saying that what we have is infidelity to the law and lazy politicians who are not even keen on creating our own laws. They pick maybe the law from the UK, they change the name United Kingdom to Kenya. Sometimes they even forget to copy-paste some of the things correctly. So we have people who are wheeler dealers and not legislators. They only think about their next deal and how they are going to make money. So that is what I can comment. Now, let me move forward to what I wanted to say today. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm angry. I'm extremely angry, especially at the realization that there are very many bodies at the city mortuary of people that died. Well, the realization of these bodies